to some Pac-12 action, and we've got a big one. A big one in Eugene, Oregon. Autzen Stadium, the Oregon Ducks hosting the Washington Huskies. And over the past few years, this one has certainly become a bit of a rivalry, I will say. It was already a rivalry, but it became even more so when Jimmy Lake was the coach at Washington and all of his comments about recruiting, et cetera, the type of players that they recruit. This has become a bit testy. Oregon is a 13.5-point favorite here. The total is 72.5, latest numbers at BetUS. It's 7 p.m. Eastern time on Fox. Oregon won last year 26-16. This looks like a completely different Oregon team this year. Washington is 2-14-1 against the spread in the last 17 against Oregon. Definitely not good. Washington 0-5 against the number in their last five. Oregon is 6-0 against the spread at home. Kyle, I want to start with you here. Michael Penix, even in very intense weather last week in Seattle, still threw for nearly 300 yards in a 24-21 win over Oregon State. You look at what Washington is doing. They're number 18 in passing success offense against Oregon, who's number 98 on defense. Oregon is number 2 in points per scoring opportunity. Washington is number 12. Like, there's a lot of things here that would lean you to believe that Washington, with that offense, could stay in it against a, we'll call it subpar Oregon defense. But, man, this thing's in Autzen. It's going to be late. It's a night game. It looks like a good spot for them. I'm curious your thoughts.
Yeah, I think what I really want to bet in this game would be an over. But, I mean, look at the number. Everybody else wants to bet an over in a game like this, too. And you have to have a cutoff point. I think both of these defenses can be had. Bo Nix has been supremely impressive to me this year. I mean, I think probably hasn't gotten enough hype for how well he's played. You know, Michael Penix, I do have to say, Penix played pretty well last week. He had that pick six, right, as the ESPN announcer was saying. His arm was so tough. He's just amazing, like a hot knife through butter. Pick six, right? The announcer jinx certainly hit him. But I think Washington, you know, last year, you said Oregon's nothing like last year's team. Yeah, Washington's nothing like last year's team either. So, you know, if you look at last year's meeting to prepare you any way for this game, then you're doing it the wrong way here. Completely different teams. I think Oregon's success on offense, you know, Nix and then Dillingham have both been very impressive. I would say that in general, this is a, you know, Washington team that I don't trust quite as much as I trust Oregon. I think Washington's defense is a little bit worse, and Washington doesn't have a great run game, so it puts quite a bit on Penix, in my opinion. So I would tend to lean toward laying the points here with the Ducks if I had to do something. Like I said, I'd really like to take an over, and if this game starts out a little bit lower scoring, I could see a live over being a good opportunity, because I do think there will be plenty of points here.
Most certainly, yeah. But looking at where it opened at 69.5, all the way up to 72.5, and it's only Wednesday. So I can only imagine this thing will go higher and higher. And yeah, if we do get a slow start, yeah, I could certainly see a live over being the play there. Parker, we'll move over to you. Oregon's offensive line, number 1 in havoc allowed over the last 5 weeks. They're only passing the ball 42% of the time. That's number 103 in the country. Their rushing success rate is number 2. In the country. Washington's defense is number 117. It is quite obvious that Oregon will be able to score on this Husky defense. And just like Kyle mentioned, this is a completely different Bo Nix that we've got this year. 73% completion percentage, 22 touchdowns, 5 picks, 2,500 yards. I mean, he's been unbelievable. But at the same time, if you look at these two teams, it's kind of carbon copies. One appears to be much better than the other, but you got two teams with a great offense and bad defenses. Just bottom line, what are you seeing the numbers with these two?
This game looks a lot to me like the Oregon-UCLA game, which I think that UCLA actually did a little better than the score there. Oregon, you know, stole possession with an onside kick, and UCLA kicked a couple field goals. But generally, UCLA moved the ball pretty well against Oregon in that game. Oregon's offense is just flying death machine against bad defenses, and UCLA has a bad defense. My prior here was actually that Oregon has a pretty bad defense, and they've struggled. But actually, when your opponent adjusts it, Oregon's defense is 46 in the Power Five. Washington's is 58. This defense is legitimately not good. And the point totals, I think, are a little bit deceptive. They're averaging allowing 26.9. You look at their last five games, they gave up 21-21 the last two, but then 39 to Arizona, 45 to Arizona State, 40 to UCLA. I mean, when they're confronted with even a competent offense, it seems like they really, really crumble. They're 115th in unadjusted EPA per play. What I also am worried about is they're much worse against the pass than the rush. They're 86th in EPA per rush allowed, but they're 123rd in EPA per pass allowed. They are 81st in quality possession rate allowed, Washington is, but they are 17th in starting field position. That means that they are putting you back against your side of the field and still letting you march down with impunity. 123rd in finishing drives, 4.89 points per echo there. So this Washington defense really is not going to be able to put up very much against this Oregon team. Oregon, I think, and I hate this, this is part of the game, Oregon is thinking about what it's going to take for them to jump in the playoff rankings to make sure that they get it, right? They're one loss right here. There's going to be some finagling. They have a common opponent with Tennessee who's going to be the other team. I think that they're going to score just a ton, just absurd. I think they want to win every game by 50 points for those style measures. And I really think that they'll be able to score. I'm worried about Washington's ability to, one, play turnover free ball, and two, finish drives at the rate that Oregon's going to finish drives. Oregon's allowing the fourth best starting field position, 25.4 yards, yard line. And Washington is 75th in starting field position. That alone means Washington's going to have to rush down the field and march down the field and score on long drives. That makes me very worried against an Oregon defense that I think is underrated just because when you account for opponent and kind of game state, they've been a little better than those numbers suggest. So I like Oregon. I like Oregon at home winning big. They are 4-0 against the spread at home here. This is a Pac-12 opponent that is severely flawed. I think Oregon's the more complete team. Dan Lanning crushing the Auburn rumors and winning by double digits. Give me the Ducks at home.
I like it. I like it a lot. We're going to make it official. Parker riding with the Ducks minus 13.5. Hey, you're getting that hook underneath two touchdowns. I could certainly understand it.